Said that Las Vegas is a town built on losers, but in the world of NHRA Mellow Yellow drag racing, victors write the history. Like the millions of hopeful tourists that come here seeking fortunes and leave with empty pockets, so too will all but a small handful of racers in the sport's professional categories. It'll be a day of boom and bust here at the 2019 Dodge NHRA Nationals, presented by Pennzoil on the grounds of the Strip at Las Vegas Motor Speedway, which sits just outside of America's greatest boom and bust city. Welcome to the pit area here at the Strip at Las Vegas Motor Speedway, alongside two-time NHRA Nitro Funny Car World Champion Tony Pedregon and eight-time NHRA Top Fuel World Champion Tony Schumacher. I'm Brian Lones, and we begin this Sunday down here at Ground Zero. Tony, you've lived this life. You've been inside these ropes. Explain to me what Sunday morning feels like late in the season.
Well, all the things that you would expect. There's some calmness. There's some nervousness. There's plenty of intensity, and I'm sure there's a lot of communication. Likely John telling Robert Height, do what you have to do. Let's get Beckman out of there. I'm going to do what I have to do. What he may not be telling them is that I feel like I have the best car. Brian Corradi knows it. John Force likely knows it. The question is, will it be as good today?
Tony Schumacher, take me into the driver's seat. What drivers tend to thrive under this pressure and what drivers collapse? What's the difference?
Well, normally you would say experience, but guys like Austin Prock and Vandergrift, man, they're proving that theory wrong. They got nothing to lose and a lot to gain. We're going to have to sit back here. Will Steve Torrence be able to go up and capitalize like he did last year?
Great view here of the fountains at the Bellagio Casino in Las Vegas as the Strip, of course, one of the great destinations in the world for entertainment of all shapes, sizes, and varieties. We are just up the road from that location. There's the view from the Lucas Oil Chopper, looking back at the city of Las Vegas, Nevada, as the final rounds are in front of us here at the Dodge NHRA Nationals, presented by Pennzoil. 23 races down now, one left to go. The World Finals in Pomona, California, the Auto Club Finals at Auto Club Raceway Pomona. Let's get into the Harley-Davidson Showdown as we talk about our final round matchup here in Pro Stock Motorcycle. And while neither of these guys may be in the thick of a championship hunt, Tony Pedregon, this is the most entertaining final round of the Pro Stock season, at least to me.
Well, it is, because there's some history here, and it goes back to that little disagreement that they had about hobbyists and professional racers. And you look at the performance, it's Steve Johnson that has been better on this day, even though Matt Smith was the number one qualifier. But in this final round, it's going to be cool, like it was when Matt set that bike on the pole.
A V-twin engine from Matt Smith, the EBR bodywork on this motorcycle. Smith was involved in some controversy outside of Steve Johnson when some bodywork was disallowed that he was using on the bike. Matt was the guy who had made all those 200-mile-an-hour runs. He had a dimpled underbelly pan on this bike that was discovered, disallowed by tech. Matt was furious about it and then proceeded to go faster with a legal declared belly pan at the next race. That was at Sonoma, California, that happened.
And ran 200, if I'm not mistaken.
I believe he did.
When he did get it up, he thought, you guys should have disqualified me a long time ago.
So Steve Johnson will find out if he can repeat that 0-11 reaction time or 0-13 reaction time he had in the semifinal round. Matt Smith was 29 on the tree in the last round. The man declared a hobbyist, trying to take down the racer, and you can see Matt Smith looking over, and Steve Johnson's having none of it. His eyes locked down the racetrack. Likely one of the peaks that these two riders will be screaming towards here momentarily. Johnson goes in quick. Matt Smith using some time here on the Christmas tree. Johnson's 3,000's better on the start. They're both down beneath the windscreens. They go past 1,000 feet. And ladies and gentlemen, Matt Smith got him by 53 ten-thousandths of a second. 18 inches at the finish line stripe. A 685. 5 beats a 686.
This is good execution. Matt Smith told us in his interview before this race he has to find a little bit more. He acknowledged the fact that Steve Johnson's had a better machine, so he knew he had to find a little performance. He knew the conditions were there, and he did exactly that.
The 24th race win of Matt Smith's career, and Tony Schumacher, you got to respect the guy that can dial it up when he needs to.
Yeah, and he sure did. He did a phenomenal job, and what a great race. You know, Steve Johnson, he, like you said earlier, he was having none of that, man. Matt's going to play a little bit there. He knows he's got his number. He's good at what he does. But Steve just kept focused, man. Looked forward and made it a great race. Really just an outstanding final round.
The type of competition we expect out of the pro stock categories, 0.0053 to the right of the decimal point, the margin of victory for Matt Smith here in Las Vegas. And he goes in keeping his hopes, however faint, alive as we see the final round or the margin of victory camera at the finish line. As Matt Smith comes around the corner, climbs off his motorcycle, we take a look at the Pro Stock motorcycle points. And Matt Smith climbs off of the number five spot, jumps over Karen Stouffer, but again, Andrew Hines is leading Jerry Savoie by 115. He needs to just not get lost on the way to Pomona, and Andrew Hines should have himself a championship. We go now to Amanda Busick and Matt Smith at the top end.
How long have we gotten out of this yet?
Not out of it yet. We just looked at the point standings, but considering the history between you and Steve Johnson and the controversy you guys had this season, what will that Wally signify for you?
It doesn't matter who's over there. A win's a win, and it's hard to get wins over here in this NHRA with the motorcycle battle, but this Denso, Lucas Oil, Mark Stock, Seth, Greg Butcher, Elite Performance, everybody helps me. Thank you, Meliella, CP Pistons, Vance and Leathers. I can't do it without any of all these guys, so thank y'all. Appreciate it.
So there is potential for a historical milestone here this afternoon as we talk about our NHRA Women of Power through the history of drag racing, especially in the NHRA. We've had women having much success. 17 different women have won races on the professional level. 149 total wins in the mellow yellow level of drag racing in NHRA for women. We could see 150 today if either Brittany Forrest or Erica Enders closes the deal. 9 different winners in Top Fuel, 9 total female championships. The first female professional level win coming in 1976 at Columbus, with Shirley Muldowney getting the job done. And Angel Sampe is the winningest female rider in the history of NHRA drag racing with 42 wins in the Pro Stock motorcycle category. This woman, Erica, seeking her 25th race win in Pro Stock car. She will be competing against a teammate for only the second time in a final round. And these two drivers are two of the best reaction time levers in the category. And coolly, we have in-car cameras for both of them. We're going to listen into the radio communications here on the starting line between these two teams. The team's not talking to each other as much as the crew chief's talking to the drivers.
These really are two of the best drivers Pro Stock's seen in a long, long time. And on the start line, they're really going to go after it here. You know, this is a big, big difference here. You know, if Erica goes on and wins this race, she's got a commanding lead. But Jeggy's not going to have any of that. Even as teammates, he's just a few rounds out and going into points and a half in Pomona. This is huge for both of them.
She has flirted with multiple victories. She has only achieved one so far in 2019. Jeg also has flirted with multiple victories, but has only achieved one in 2019. And there's Rick Jones providing the encouragement to Erica. His son Ricky stands behind Jeg Coughlin Jr. as the crew chief on that car. Father versus son in the setup department, and teammates against each other on the starting line. Pro Stock final round Vegas. Wind them up and dump the clutch. Here we go. 0:18 reaction time for Erica as they get past the finish line stripe for the 150th time in the history of NHRA drag racing. A woman has won a professional category. 6.617 seconds, 208 miles an hour. Erica Enders will go to Pomona, California with a 92-point lead over the rest of the field, nearly insurmountable. And congratulations to the Chevrolet brand as they have just picked up their 200th win in Pro Stock Eliminator. greeted by Angie Smith, one of the women who has won on the professional level in NHRA drag racing, as we're going to take a look at how this worked out for Erica.
Well, Erica had some catching up to do, not on the starting line. She had a big lead. She never saw, never heard Jeg, but her car was behind at the eighth mile. Jeg Coughlin just fell off at the wrong time. Both these drivers sized one another up. I think we all knew, and even including these two drivers, knew that it's probably going to come down to the starting line advantage. Both these cars were equally matched coming into this race, and it was Erica jamming those gears, and Jeg Coughlin just seeing that car the total length of the track and just couldn't catch her.
After all the frustrations of a 2019 season, Eric Anders goes in as a championship favorite to Pomona. Here she is with Amanda.
The 150th Wally for women goes in the hand of Erica Anders. At a track that has been so good to you in your career, could you imagine a more perfect location for this milestone?
No, Amanda, I could not. Vegas has been the ultimate place for us at this Elite Motorsports team. I'm so happy. I'm so thrilled. I'm just trying to slow down. My dad and my sister and some of my friends really walked me through this mentally, but my team are the men that stand behind me. I thank Richard Freeman for the opportunity. Mark Ingersoll and Rick Jones, they're my boys, man. Ricky Jones and Lump as well. But for everybody that touches this car, I can't thank them enough. I give God all the glory, for it's through him I can do all things. I'm so proud of my team, Amanda, so proud.
And here is the Pro Stock points. Right now, as we mentioned, Erica 92 points ahead of the man she just defeated in the final round, Jeg Coughlin Jr. Then it's Bo Bundner and Jason Lyon, and it seems like a very distant dream for both of those racers to get in this thing. And Matt Harford, who came in as the number two racer in points in Pro Stock, finds his way down near the bottom of the list right now. We have two finals down. We have multiple finals to go. If you think it's exciting now, wait till you come back and see what we got planned for Funny Car and Top Fuel.
Devil in the deep blue sea, I'll be your preacher, will you follow me? No more chains around you now, you're free, free to be who you want to be. Hear me now, Lord, can you hear me now? No, I won't.
A great look there at our two final round competitors in Top Fuel, but it's time for the Funny Car Final here, and not one that we could have drawn up from the beginning of this day, as Johnny Lindbergh has weaved his way through the rounds with a very solid Jim Head tune-up and very nice driving. And Matt Hagan has done what he did in Dallas, Texas, which was to show up and just romp and stomp his way through these rounds. This car has been nothing short of spectacular since we started drag racing 2 weeks ago in Dallas. They had not missed a beat coming here.
Like Johnny Lindbergh, this team has found their sweet spot during eliminations. Nothing impressive during qualifying, a couple of big victories in that semifinal, taking Tasca out and really moving himself in a position that this final round for him becomes more and more important going into the next race.
For Jim Head, the owner of this car, the last time he won a race as a driver or a tuner was Memphis, Tennessee in 1997. For Matt Hagan, if he's able to pull this out, he would end up 56 points out of first place. And Tony Schumacher, you know better than anybody else. You're 56 points out of first coming into Pomona. You got a shot.
It's outstanding. I'm looking at the sheet here. He actually will have the same chance as Jack Beckman or John Force.
They're in. Leave close. A little movement there for Lindbergh, and it's Matt Hagan. Matt Hagan, 387.6, 331.76 miles an hour. Dickie Venables and that whole team have found the magic, and they will be bringing it, and they will be swinging the big hammer when they come to Pomona looking to beat up on Robert Height.
Well, both Dickie Venables with myself in 2007. As a tuner, he's been here not once or twice, a few times. He's been here with Matt Hagan. Matt Hagan has been in this situation, has seen this scenario a few times, and he finds himself coming, rising from the ashes and going into Pomona with more momentum than anyone.
Our Evans Crew Chief Confidential this week will be with Dickie Venables, the first two-time winning crew chief on the countdown.
Dickie, the performance of this car the past 2 weeks is truly impressive. The switch to the 6-disc clutch early this season looks to be paying off in spades.
It is. I mean, we kind of knew that's what needed to be in there, but we were struggling with it. But it just takes time. It takes runs, and fortunately we're able to do that and get the thing where it needs to be. What a great job Matt did all weekend. Drove his butt off. My guys, I can't say enough about them. Flawless. Great for Don Schumacher Racing. We're happy to get the win.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Two championship drivers in the room with me. This guy, whenever he decides to hang it up, I hope it's not for many, many years, but he will rank as one of the really, really good guys, if not one of the greats. He's rock solid.
Yeah, and he can really separate himself. I mean, he's got two championships. I do, Cruz does. Caps has one. I mean, there's a lot of drivers with two other than the one that really took the lion's share. That's his name is John Forrest. But Matt Hagan, he could really be in that conversation along with Robert Height to really separate themselves and have three championships in funny car.
Yeah, I've had an opportunity for a long, long time now to be able to watch his performance grow and get better and better. And he truly is a beast. He gets on that start line. He gets amped up. He drives the car straight. And look, he's been through it. He's been on fire. He's been upside down. He's crashed. He cowboys up. He gets in the car and pulls it together when he needs it.
And for Johnny Lindbergh, 3.945 seconds in the final. Nothing to be ashamed of there. They made full power runs all weekend long. Robert Height leads Jack Beckman by 46, Matt Hagan by 56, and John Forrest by 72. Those are the fearsome foursome that will be the closest in the final round or elimination rounds in Pomona. And we now go to the top end and talk to a two-time back-to-back funny car winner, Matt Hagan.
And he just said, we're back in this thing. You're only 56 points back as you enter into Pomona with back-to-back wins. How will you use this momentum?
We're just thankful to be here, very blessed, you know, glory goes to God. But you know what? The president of Mopar's here. We got this a Penzel deal right here, too. It's a Dodge Nationals. I'll tell you what, it all worked out and lined up. We got some lady luck this weekend. But I want to just say thank you to my guys that bust their ass and worked so hard on this car to come back from not thinking we're going to really be in it to now we're right in the thick of this hump with points and a half in Pomona. I love my guys. And Dickie Venables, badass job, brother. Love you.
Woo! Yeah! Yes! Yes!
Now we see Brittany Forrest, the 1,000-yard glare down the racetrack, the 150th female victory in the Male Yellow Drag Racing Series. Right now, you can see where the milestone wins have come, and you see where the women rank as far as their win totals. Erica Enders now second all-time. Brittany Forrest seeking her 10th, her first win at Gainesville in 2016. Great spread of classes for those female competitors there as well. Pro Stock Motorcycle, Top Fuel, and Nitro Funny Car all represented. One of those races you're almost sad to see end. This has been an incredibly entertaining Sunday here of high-quality competition, upsets. And then we see this. We see Brittany Forrest on the right side. We see Steve Torrence on the left side. I want your perspective here at Tony Schumacher. Have the conditions, has the racetrack, has the temperature come to David Grubnick in one of his double throwdown tune-ups?
Well, you can't count Torrence out, but yes.
Brittany gets the jump by almost 200ths of a second, and Brittany Forrest. 365-2, 334 crushing miles an hour as Brittany Forrest takes victory from Steve Torrence and goes into Pomona, California, riding a wave in that big red Advanced Auto Parts dragster.
Well, started right at the starting line. I talked about that confidence, and this sun gets off the track, and these drivers are able to zone into that amber light and when to go, and she was just focused. She was more focused than Steve Torrence on that run, and then on top of that, to compound his problems, her tuner gave her the car he had Friday night. And then Saturday night. So it was pretty much a runaway victory for that Force team.
Bruno Massa was with a very happy David Grubnick.
David Grubnick, 338. Then you go out here and go 365 in the final. Is it safe to say you finally got a handle on this unit? Because it sure looks like it to everybody else.
Well, so far, so good. We'll have a look at the engine, see what it looks like. You know, we made it through all day today with the same engine. I don't know how that one's going to be. But, you know, we're still in the fight. You know, that is a very strong team, Torrence. They got years on us with their setup. You know, we've got conditions that are conducive to our car, so, you know, it will take the battle to Pomona. It's sure getting exciting, isn't it?
That is a genuine smile on that man's face. Her second race win of the season, her first race win ever here at this event, and her 10th win of her career. Watch it happen from the Lucas Oil Chopper.
What, you know, she wiggles a little bit down the track, but she was pulling away from the hit of the throttle. She had a couple hundredths of a second on the start line and never looked back. And, you know, I'm almost starting to feel like I know what I'm talking about up here. Grubnick, this is exactly right. We all called that one. He was going to go after it. And unless Steve could step it up and keep up with Grubnick's guys, they weren't going to win that race.
What a scene this sets up for Pomona as we go down to the 151st female winner in NHRA Mellow Yellow Drag Racing history. Here she is, Brittany Forrest.
Well, Brittany, as you said, you've seen this place before, chasing Steve Torrence into Pomona. You've done it once. Why can you be the 2019 champ?
That is exactly what we're going for. This is Advance Auto Parts team. David Grubnick, Max Savage, they've been killing it all weekend long. So proud of this entire team. And I'll tell you right now, we've been here before. We got the job done. And I bet you Steve is shaking in his boots right now.
Wait, Brittany.
I like it. I like it. I like it a lot. That is exactly what I want to see and hear going into Pomona, California. And they are coming in hot, make no mistake about it, and Steve Torrence has nothing to hang his head about. That was a great weekend for that team, as they tend to have here. As we look at our top fuel points, this is the way it is now. What did it look like coming in? It doesn't matter. This is what it looks like now. Brittany Force only 16 points behind Torrence, and how about Doug Coletta was probably high-fiving his pals, because he's now only 55 out. It could be better for him, but it could be a whole heck of a lot worse. So Doug Coletta, Brittany Force, and Steve Torrence, the three closest, and Billy Torrence lingering back there at 86 points behind. This is the way the points break down at Pomona, California for the Auto Club Finals. We see Pomona 2 on the right side. All those points will be up for grabs. We've had a few drivers eliminated, but we've had no championships locked down in any one of our four mellow yellow categories. Now let's go down to the Sunoco Winner Circle at the top end. 150 and 151 wins for female competitors in the NHRA Mellow Yellow Drag Racing Series. Matt Hagan goes 2 in a row, and Matt Smith picks up another win on his great, great season and career. Thank you so much to Tony Schumacher, to Bruno Massel, Amanda Busick, Tony Pedregon, and Lewis Bloom. We have one race left in this 2019 season, and it is going to be a barn burner out there in Pomona, California. That's what our coverage looks like Friday, 5:30 p.m., Sunday at 3, and then the final round eliminations at 4 p.m. Eastern on FS1. Thank you for tuning in to Vegas. If you're not going to be at the SEMA show, watch us on NHRA.com. We'll see you there.